Okay. Hello, everybody. I am on, and I'm just going to wait to see who comes on. I'm getting ready to make this chicken pot pie, these chicken pot pies, and I'm going to make, hello, everybody. I'm getting ready to make the chicken pot pies. Welcome to my channel, my YouTube channel, Fabulously Functional, my Facebook page. Actually, this is not my personal page. This is Bev's Midday Cafe that we're on. So we're on Bev's Midday Cafe and we're on YouTube. And I see one person trying to figure out who that is. Not sure who that is. But yeah, I decided to come on live now. It's about 5:22. Getting close to time when people are trying to get home or getting home, maybe cooking or whatever you're doing. You can always come back and watch it later. Yeah, I'm gonna make those chicken pot pies. Actually, not chicken. I used to make the chicken, the cornbread chicken pot pies, but this time it's just gonna be vegetables. And it's gonna be delicious, I believe it is. So, we're gonna go ahead and get started. I'm waiting to see who's coming on. I don't know. I see two people. Hopefully you can hear me and see me. More. Okay. Okay, I'm back. I don't know what I did, y'all. I disappear. Okay, so I'm back. Hi, Rhonda. Hello, my dear. I see others that are on. I just don't know who they are, but I apologize. I'm still learning. Pray for me. But yeah, so I want to make those cornbread veggie pot pies. And then we're going to do those oatmeal cookies that I said I was going to come back on and do. So good evening to you, Rhonda Morrison, and any of the others that are on. I see you coming on and off. Hopefully you're not having any technical difficulties. Yeah, I got comments. Yeah, okay. All right. Hi, Rhonda. All right. So, All right, so let's get started. We're gonna go ahead and get started. I'm gonna turn your attention down to this table right here. Hopefully you can see it. All right. There we go. So I gotta turn this so that it's, and let's see. Hi, Sister Russell. How are you, my dear? I'm on this new platform and I'm totally confused about a lot of stuff. I'm just learning how to work it. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this over here. I'm going to bring this camera over here like that. And then I'm going to drop the camera down just a little bit so you can see all of what I have over here, the ingredients and all that stuff. Okay, so I'm making cornbread chicken pot pies. No, cornbread pot pies, no chicken. I used to put the chicken. Yeah, but I don't do that anymore because we are plant-based slash vegan. So I'm gonna get out my handy dandy skillet that I love to use. Good evening again to everyone that's coming on. And you may have to watch it later, but that's okay. So I got my skillet right here that I'm going to put right here. And I've got to learn how this camera, it turns different. So, all right. So in this pan right here, I'm going to add two, this hot pan, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of vegan butter. Okay. 2 tablespoons of vegan butter. That's 1 and 2. Put the rest of this over here. Because I'm gonna need the rest of that for those cookies. Okay, so 2 tablespoons of butter. And what I'm gonna be doing is sauteing my onion, a half a cup of chopped onion, and a half a cup of celery. So here's my half a cup of chopped celery and my half a cup of chopped onion. Celery's right here. Onions right here. Okay, I'm going to put it into the boil here. And we're going to let that simmer until it becomes translucent. The other ingredient that you see here on the plate is parsley, and I'm going to chop that up to where it's like maybe a tablespoon. It doesn't look like a tablespoon because it's not been chopped up yet. So I'm going to chop that up. and make that to become a tablespoon. Sharp knife. Once I chop it up real good, it'll look more like a tablespoon. Get some of these stems out of the way. We don't want the stems. All parsley. Be so careful. These knives are sharp. I get myself. That's Dr. Wood's greatest fear is that I cut myself. He doesn't like it when I cut. Okay. So that may be a little more than a tablespoon, but it's okay. So it's chopped up. It's a coarse chop. That's going to go in there as well. Right now, we're going to make these onions. Half a cup of onion, chopped onion, half a cup of celery, and 2 tablespoons of vegan butter. And we're going to let those simmer until they become translucent. When I say translucent, I mean, you know, they kind of have that clear look to them. That means they're nice and tender. So we're going to do that. Let that continue to simmer right there. I already have my oven heated to 375 degrees. So that's the temperature you're going to cook this at. And I have here, I was going to do my vegan cornbread from scratch, but Dr. Wood loves Jiffy, and I use the vegetarian Jiffy. You see that? It's vegetarian. And I take the vegetarian Jiffy, and I turn it vegan. I turn it totally vegan. So vegetarian and vegan are not the same thing. So the way I turn the vegetarian Jiffy vegan is I add, instead of using regular milk or an egg, I use a plant-based egg and I use almond milk. And that's how I turn the Jiffy vegetarian brand into vegan. Okay. So while this is turning translucent, I'm going to go ahead and show you how to make that vegan egg so that it's ready when I get ready to mix the cornbread. So I have here chickpea flour, and 1 egg is 3 tablespoons of chickpea flour and 3 tablespoons of water. You mix it, you let it set till it gets to the consistency, really, of an egg. I'm going to need 2 because I have 2 boxes of Jiffy, and it only calls for 1 egg. So I'm going to need 6 tablespoons of chickpea flour and 6 tablespoons of water. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. I got my bowl here. Just got to get my tablespoon. Okay, I got a half a tablespoon. My tablespoon must be dirty or in the dishwasher. So that means, let me see. Just may be ready. No, it's not. Okay, turn this down just a little bit. So they're becoming translucent. They're becoming translucent faster than I thought. Okay, and if you look at them, you can see, bring them up close. They are translucent. So since they're already translucent, I'm gonna hold off on the chickpea eggs and go ahead and do the next step. So I have here, the next thing I'm going to add is 2 cups of vegetable stock. I made my own stock, and so the stock is made from celery, peppercorns, bay leaf, and onion, and a little bit of salt. And so from that, I have made my own stock. I'm going to pour 2 cups of it into the pan here with the onion. Turn that fire back up. All right, and with that, I'm going to add, instead of a cup of dairy milk, I'm going to add a cup of almond milk to this mixture. Just going to pour it in there like that. And let that begin to heat up once again. That's heating up, I'm going to take 6 tablespoons of unbleached flour, 6 tablespoons. And I'm going to add half a cup of water to this. Mix it up to where it's a nice little consistency. And then we're going to put it in there and allow that mixture to become thick. So, yeah, I'm going to add half a cup of water. I'm just going to put that water right in here. And I've got some alkaline water sitting right here, so that's good. So half a cup of water. A spoon. I'm going to stir it right in here in this container. I'm going to stir it in here till it's kind of smooth. Like that. Once it's kind of smooth, then I'm going to whisk it into the mixture here. The milk, the vegetable stock, the onion, and the celery. Okay, so you can see how it's kind of smoothing out here, almost to a consistency of a dressing, a salad dressing. Sure, I got all of the. All right, now I gotta get my wire whisk. Right here. There. Smooth it out a little more with the wire whisk. All right, and then so I'm going to pour. There we go. This down some. I'm going to make sure you got a good picture of what I'm doing here. All right, there we go. So I'm going to pour the flour water mixture into the pan here. I'm going to whisk, whisk, whisk. It's going to get thick here just a little bit. It's already getting thick. Now, this recipe that I'm doing typically calls for chicken. So I'm going to add extra vegetables to fill up the space where the chicken would be in this mixture. So, and you can see it's nice and creamy. Onions are in there, the celery's in there, just looks wonderful. So now I'm gonna start adding my vegetables. Calls for a 10-ounce package of vegetables, but I'm going to add extra vegetables because there's no chicken. So I'm going to turn this down just a little bit. The vegetables I have chosen, you can do, you know, your typical mixed vegetables, or you can fix it up like you want. So I've got broccoli, cauliflower, carrots, and peas. So I've thawed them. These are the frozen ones. I've thawed them, and so they have a little bit of juice in them. So I'm just going to squeeze the juice out of them and put them in to the sauce. Squeeze the juice out because I don't want any extra juice in my sauce. So I'm squeezing the juice out of the thawed frozen vegetables. And you know, if you look here, I got about a fourth of a cup of juice that I have squeezed out of these frozen vegetables. Now that's just the frozen vegetables. I'm also going to add some, these are diced redskin potatoes, gently cooked, pre-cooked. So they're not raw, they're gently pre-cooked. So I'm going to go ahead and add those. And this, I think, is enough potatoes to replace where there may have been chicken. Okay. So I've got those in there. Also going to add some fresh cut from the cob corn. This is only one piece of corn cob, one whole corn cob cut from it. And I'm going to just go ahead and add that in there. I'm going to stir this. Boy, that looks so good, y'all. All right, and the color is wonderful. See the color? Okay. All right, next I'm going to add, let that simmer some. I'm going to add some seasonings. So I'm going to add a little bit of dried organic basil. I'm going to add about a fourth of a teaspoon of black pepper. Or you could use white pepper. I'm also going to use some salt-free seasoning for some extra flavors, extra spices, salt-free seasoning. And then I am going to put a pinch or two of pink Himalayan salt. Stir that. Like so, like that. Y'all, this looks so good. I'm getting ready to taste it here in a minute. Okay, the next thing I'm going to add is what happened to my parsley? So I'm going to add the fresh chopped parsley here. Chop it up just a little bit more. That. Hi, Morgan. Hi, Leslie. How y'all doing? So there's my fresh parsley. Leslie, I know you remember these pot pies, the chicken ones, but it's not chicken this time. It's just vegetable. But I just tend to think it's going to be just as good. It's going to be topped with my vegan cornbread. And so I want to taste this and just see if the seasonings are on point. I thought about adding some asparagus too. What do you guys think? Should I add some asparagus? So I've got red skin potatoes, carrots, broccoli, corn, peas. Should I add some asparagus? Y'all, that is good. But it still needs some more seasoning in there. It's good. But we need some more pepper. We need some more salt-free seasoning. And we need a little bit more just salt. I'm gonna put two more pinches. Okay. And give it a stir again. We're gonna taste it again. So should I add asparagus? Oh, thank you, Leslie. Okay, I'm gonna taste it again. Always start light with seasonings and then, you know, add because once you add too much, you can't take it out. So it was good, but it needed a little more punch to it. So I'm gonna see if that did it. We're getting there. We're getting there. Let me see what I got up here. I think I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic powder and a teeny bit of paprika. I haven't even opened this garlic powder. Okay. Gonna pull a little garlic powder go a long way. Yes, it do. And just a touch, not a lot, but a touch of paprika. I'm gonna stir that in there and see what it do. Gonna tell y'all what, it looks delicious. All right, you gotta give me another spoon. Because I don't do no double dipping. Not even with my family. That did it. That did it. Yes, it did. Now, the other thing I'm going to add to it, where is it? This is a staple for all vegan chefs. Bragg's nutritional yeast. Now, Bragg's makes it. There's other brands, but this is nutritional yeast. And so I'm going to add some of that. Adds a wonderful nutty flavor. To anything you're cooking. If you just want to add a different flavor to give it some specialness, add that nutritional yeast in there. And it's going to give it a wonderful flavor. If you don't want to add it, you don't have to. But I will maybe. I want to add it because that's my business. All right, I'm gonna taste this. Caught some pepper. Okay. All right. So, all right. Add a little bit of pepper, got in my throat, y'all. But this is perfect now. So what I'm gonna do, I gotta show you. When I did my live earlier today, I said I went and bought these little Pyrex dishes. So I'm gonna make him two small ones, and then I'm gonna make a big one. So it's thickening up really good, and I think it's thick enough because it does have to bake too. All right. So I'm only going to fill it to about right there because I got to have room for my cornbread to sit on top and to bake. And one thing about baking the cornbread on top is if you put too much, it'll bubble over and bubble out. So you put just enough. So I left about an inch right there. Okay. But so I got that in there. I'm gonna set that back there. I got another little Pyrex dish, so he'll have two for a couple of days to go with all the other stuff. Okay, see how I left about an inch space there? Right, and then I'm gonna do a big one. I got a big Pyrex dish. Jasmine liable to come pick this one up. We're just gonna put I don't know if I should put the rest. I'm trying to see how much. Because like I said, I need space. I think I'll be good. Go ahead and put all of this in here. And then I'm going to top it some cornbread. Okay. All right. Turn that off. Okay, so there it is. That's the mixture. All right, so now we're going to do our cornbread. I'm going to bring you back over this way a little bit. Going to need two boxes of Jiffy. Vegetarian Jiffy. What you say? Hold my arms up. Girl, I'm done now. Thanks, Leslie, though. Thank you. There's one box. Here's another box. Okay, there's another box. And then I'm going to need to make those chickpea eggs. So that's 6 tablespoons of chickpea flour and 6 tablespoons of water, which will give me 2 eggs because 1 egg is 3 tablespoons of chickpea flour and 3 tablespoons of water. So I only have my half a tablespoon here. So I got to do 12 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then I need 12 half tablespoons of water. 1, 2, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. All right. I'm using my alkaline water here. But you can use any water you wish. So I'm going to stir that up. Stir that up. Like that. I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder. I think that's 1/4 teaspoon. 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder. I need 2/3 cup milk, because one box of Jiffy is 1/3. So I need 2/3 cup of milk. Let's see. I need this side. 2/3 cup. I can't see, y'all. That's 3/4 here. 2/3. And you guys know I'm using almond milk. Okay, so 2/3 cup almond milk. I've got that. I've got the Jiffy mix. And then here are my 2 eggs. I'll go ahead and add that. If you look at it, looks like scrambled eggs before you cook them. In fact, you can take the same mixture and actually fry it in the pan as if it were eggs. Just saying. Now we're going to stir this up. We get this. Yep. Remember what it does, like a little sweetness to his cornbread. Jiffy's already kind of sweet. But I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit more in here. And as you can see, it's kind of thick, which is a good thing. It needs to be. Am I only going to add maybe 1 teaspoon of unrefined organic sugar? I forgot. The other thing I'm supposed to add is some, I think I'm supposed to add some oil, if I'm not mistaken. I'm so used to doing it by scratch. 1/3 cup of milk. Nope. No oil. But I think I need to add a little butter. I think I am. I'm gonna melt some. I'm going to melt about 2 tablespoons of butter. Up here in the microwave. I wonder if it's Roxanne on. She says, you use so many dishes. She said, who's washing all those dishes? Well, the dishwasher. But I do have to rinse them. Okay, let's see. I bet shit already melted. It was only two. All right, so this little red bone got hot. Okay. All right. That makes it a little smoother, just a little bit more richer. Okay, and so now what I do is I take these little dishes with the mixture in. Get me a spoon. And I'm going to spoon the cornbread mixture right on top. And I start at the edge, and then I pull it to the middle. So I start at the edge, and I come inside just like that. And you lay it right on top of here. And it's going to bake right on top of this wonderful mixture of sauce and vegetables. Okay, so you see that? I'll put that in the oven. Let's do this other one. Mmm. That cornbread is good. I just tasted it. Get that. Okay, so there's my second little pot pie. And then here's the big one. I'm just going to finish off all the rest of this cornbread mix. On top of here. Gradually go around in a circle here. Till it's all covered. And then I'll smooth it out. So I'm going to take the back of my spoon, smooth it out, carry it over to the edges, make sure everything's covered. Like that. Okay, and so now it's ready to go into the oven. Let me back this up just a little bit. I'm gonna open the oven. Oh, I got my baked potatoes in here. He loves baked potatoes, so I'm making him some of those. And my baked potatoes take a little while longer because I wrap them in parchment first and then put the foil around them. Because when you bake in aluminum, believe it or not, you're getting aluminum in your food, which is not good for you. Oh, these are ready, too. They're nice and tender. They are nice and tender. All right. So, pull this out. All right, so I'm going to take this one, put it on the cookie sheet. I want to use the cookie sheet because these small ones are a little bit unstable if they're just on the rack. Put that one in there. Put that one right there. And just in case they bubble over, I won't get it all down in my oven. So, sorry. So these need to bake for 40 minutes to an hour. Now, if it was one whole chicken pot pie, it probably would take an hour. But because I've broken it down into three pies, it's not going to take it that long. It's not going to take those little ones as long as it's going to take that big one. So we're going to set it for 30 minutes and then see what happens. And it's already set at 375. Okay. Okay, now we gotta make our cookies. Okay, while that's cooking, we're gonna work on this oatmeal cookie dough. Okay. So I'm gonna get rid of some stuff over here. I'm gonna get rid of this chickpea flour, all these dishes. There we go. All this can go here. This can go here. The bottle here has 50-50 peroxide and water. And peroxide is a disinfectant and it doesn't leave any strong smells. Perfumes, these cleaners for those of us who have asthma and breathing conditions. Some of the fumes from these cleaning agents just send us into a breathing attack. And so, peroxide and water, 50-50, and sometimes just straight peroxide. Believe it or not, hospitals, places, medical places use peroxide to sanitize and wipe down. I'm talking about hydrogen peroxide. That's what's in that bottle. When you go into these places, these medical buildings, always a fresh scent. The other thing I found out is that, like when you put onion in plastic containers, and even though you wash them till they're squeaky clean, it still has that onion smell in them. What you do is after you wash them till they're squeaky clean, you spray this in them, let it sit, takes the scent away. Takes it away. Yes, it does. Okay. I got a lot of dishes to wash. Merciful Father. Okay, so now we're gonna get started on these oatmeal cookies. Yay! I got all the ingredients right here. Oats. And I got to bring you back over this way so you can see. Okay, so oats, raisins, vanilla, cinnamon, nutmeg, organic unsweetened applesauce, organic coconut palm sugar, which replaces the brown sugar. And unbleached all-purpose organic flour by King Arthur. Now, I believe that is all the ingredients. Oh, nope. Baking soda. You can't have cookies without baking soda and baking powder. No, those cookies will not get up if you don't have these two things right here. So, All right, so we have that, and I've got my two mixing bowls for my standing mixer. So I'm going to bring my standing mixer over. I forgot. I need a half a stick of vegan butter. And I believe that's a half a stick. Let me make sure. That half? That may be a little more than half. So we're going to cut that right here. It's supposed to be a fourth of a cup of butter. And yeah, so that's going to be my measuring stick, the other stick of butter. So I have to preheat the oven to 350. Right now, the oven is at 375, so I'm going to have to bring it down just a little bit. I want y'all to see this cornbread is already rising on these things. It's going to spill over. But that's okay. It's still going to be good. So in a large bowl, I'm going to cream together vegetable shortening and sugars with an electric mixer. And I have an electric mixer. What they're saying is you gotta make sure that stuff is beat in there. So we're gonna bag all these ingredients up. I'm gonna put my electric mixer right here where you can see it. Bring it up. Can bring the camera in some. Get far away. There we go. Okay, so you can see this, I'm sure. All right. This is my big bowl. And I need 1/4 cup of vegetable shortening. And I'm going to be using this vegan butter instead. So 1/4 cup. I'm just gonna say that that's 1/4 cup. But I think I'm maybe a tablespoon too much. Okay, so I'm gonna put that in there, 1/4 cup, which is half of a stick, because a whole stick of butter, a vegan butter or any kind of butter, is a half a cup. So a fourth of a cup is gonna be half a stick. So we're gonna do that with the sugars and an electric mixer. So I'm supposed to have 1/4 cup of regular sugar and 1/4 cup of brown sugar. My brown sugar is going to be the organic coconut sugar. Let me get my measuring cup. Okay, so here's a fourth of a cup. It has that caramel flavor and color of the brown sugar. So it's a fourth of a cup of organic coconut palm sugar. And then I also need a fourth of a cup of organic cane sugar. Okay. That in there. And then we're going to get mixing here. Mixers. Gotta put this one in first, and then put this one. Okay. We're gonna slowly mix that up. This is a vintage Sunbeam mix master. It's the quietest mix master I've ever heard. Ever. Just as quiet as it wants to be. It away from the edge. Oh, And so I gotta mix that. And then I'm gonna add vanilla, applesauce, almond milk, and mix until well combined. I only need 1/4 of a cup of almond milk. So I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna go ahead and pour that. 1/4 of a cup in my little wrong side. That's a half of a cup. I need 1/4 my cup. One fourth is, I think that's about right. I'd use this, but yeah, that's about right. Okay, applesauce, also 1/4 of a cup of applesauce. Is unsweetened organic applesauce. So we're going to go ahead and add that in here. Applesauce. Almond milk. And the vanilla extract. And a vanilla extract, we need, what's it say here? Half a teaspoon. All right, there's a half a teaspoon. I'm gonna speed it up here so that can fluff up. Let's mix some pretty good. Vegan butter and organic coconut sugar blend a little bit differently, but that's okay. I think we're still gonna be good. Once we add those dry ingredients. Right, so while that's mixing, we're going to go ahead and put our dry ingredients together. And of course, that's going to start off with a cup of flour. And I have here my organic unbleached king arthur flour. Get a bowl. I level it off because one thing about baking is very precise. So when I fill my cup up with the flour, I tap it to make sure all the flour is falling down, and then I scrape it off. So that's perfect 1 cup of flour. The other dry ingredients we're going to be adding are 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Well, it says 1/8. 1/8. So we could do 1/8. This is 1/4, so half of this. 1/8 teaspoon of salt, half a teaspoon of baking soda. It's going to be two of these. This is 1/4. 1/8. Half a teaspoon of baking soda. 1/4 of a teaspoon of baking powder. A baking powder, a teaspoon, cinnamon, and half a teaspoon of nutmeg. Here's my half a teaspoon of nutmeg, and a teaspoon of cinnamon. Here's my teaspoon. That's a lot of cinnamon, isn't it? But he said a teaspoon, so I'm gonna do it. It's not my recipe. This is organic cinnamon. Okay. That's a teaspoon. Half teaspoon of nutmeg. Okay. All right. Then I got my oats, half a cup of rolled oats and half a cup of raisins. I got that right. But I need to mix up these dry ingredients first. Got my cinnamon, my baking soda, my nutmeg, my flour, my salt, my baking powder. I'm mixing it right here. And I'm going to now add that to this mixture. And slow it down just a little bit because we got flour flying everywhere. Some of it off the edge. That smells good and looks good, y'all. Okay, so to this. I'm gonna add half a cup of rolled oats, half a cup of raisins. Here's my raisins. I had just half a cup in here, y'all. What? Oh my goodness. That ain't nobody but Jesus. Okay, so I got that. And now I got my half a cup of rolled oats. Okay. Okay, I think I'm gonna turn it off now. It's kind of thick. Tap these. Get all that. All my cookie dough off of here. and my raisins. Got a few raisins caught in there. Okay. So there's my dough. I have a cookie scooper, and I'm going to use parchment. They say, you know, a greased cookie sheet, but I'm going to use parchment. And so we got to check on my cookie sheet is in here with the chicken pot pies. Oh my goodness, y'all. They look wonderful, but they're not quite ready yet. They're not quite ready yet. So I've got my cookies here. Maybe I can use this huge cookie sheet, put parchment on it. This thing is huge. But it can do the trick. I'd rather use parchment. And certainly while that is so I've got my cookie sheet here, right here, and I'm going to do my cookie scooper. This is supposed to be, you know, the size of a cookie is cookie scooper, so I'm going to try this and see what happens. Let me just, I want to taste this dough. These cookies gonna be good. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay. So here we go. I'm just gonna do them by the spoonfuls, by the scoopfuls, and put them on here. Some of them are going to be a little bit bigger than other ones, but it's okay. Maybe I did need the big cookie sheet. These are a lot of cookies. Or maybe they're supposed to be bigger. I'm not sure. But we're going to find out, ain't we? So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times 3, that's 15 cookies. That's a little bit more than a baker's dozen. So I'm just going to stick this one over here and make 16 cookies. All right. And if y'all don't mind, the one thing about cooking vegan is you can eat the stuff because there's no raw egg in here. I can sit up here and scrape this bowl, and these are gonna be good, y'all. For real, for real. Oh my goodness. Tastes like a bowl of oatmeal loaded with cinnamon, maple brown sugar, No, these gonna be good. Now, I said I was making forever with it, but some of these going on the road trip with me. They going with me. I'm taking some. Okay. Let me see who all on here. Who all on here? Wise Warrior, hello. Teresa, Mother Leslie, Morgan Elizabeth, that's my niece. Sister Russell, Rhonda Morrison. So I got 9 people on here. I don't know who the other people are. But don't be jealous. Girl, I done gave you the recipe. This recipe came from, just by the way, and I did make some changes to it. Like where it said a cup of brown sugar, I used organic coconut sugar. Let's see, what else did I? That's about the only thing I changed. Oh, instead of using a cup of shortening, a half a fourth of a cup of shortening, I used a half a stick of vegan butter. So that's the only difference for me in this recipe. I did not use vegetable shortening and I did not use maple brown sugar. I used different things. So I got new comments. Hungry, everybody hungry, everybody hungry and jealous. Oh my goodness. So I'm trying to wait until these pot pies get done. Oh my goodness, they're bubbling, y'all. They may be ready. Hold on. Hold your meal. Let me see. Yeah, it's at 375. But are these supposed to be at 375? No, these are supposed to be at 350. So I gotta bring these down. And I gotta bring the temperature down on this oven. Anyway, but I want y'all to see these. I want you to see. Look at here. Look. There they are. I'm gonna bring the camera closer. Y'all see that? They still bubbling, but there's the cornbread, and I love it when it cracks. That's how you know it's ready. See, you got the crack in the cornbread right there. And let me tell you what I typically do. This is what I do. While it's hot, I take some butter and I spread it on top of that cornbread like that. Rum Water may eat one of these tonight. He just may do it. When he see it, he gonna be like, "What?" He already a country boy. He love cornbread. So you put cornbread on anything for him, he gonna tear it up. As intelligent as he is a country boy. Country. All right, I'm gonna put some butter over here on this one as well. But you see that? Just let it melt and put this one over here. You're gonna need a little more over here. Go around the edges like that. Oh, honey chow. Honey. Okay, bedroom. So y'all see that? There it is. And you see underneath how that cornbread has cooked down into the, it has cooked down into the, down into the mixture. So these, I wish y'all could smell it. Okay, so these are done. It took about 30 minutes, and that's good. I mean, that's pretty much right because I broke the pie down into three. So, if I don't cook them too long, then Reverend Woodard, if he wants to stick it in the oven, then he can stick it in the oven. He likes to warm up his food in the oven. And you know, it could get like a little more brown on the top if he wants. But these the top is nice and crunchy and crisp, which is why that butter melted so smoothly. So that is, those are the vegetable cornbread pot pies. Honey, y'all should smell them. Okay. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put these oatmeal cookies in. And I'm trying to see how long they're supposed to cook for 15 minutes. So we're gonna put them in there. It's probably gonna be 15 because even though I turned it down, the oven's still a little bit warmer than 350. So I'll go ahead and get that started on 15 minutes. I almost want to dig into this one big pie back here so y'all can see me taste it. Y'all can see me taste it. What you think? Should I do it? I was thinking maybe taking this one with me or either Jasmine coming to get it. But these two can definitely be for Dr. Woodard. While I'm gone, that's two different meals there for him. So Leslie, you'll have to try my new pot pies without the chicken. Definitely won't be the same, but it's worth a try. It's worth a try. So we're gonna wait till I got about 15 minutes before these cookies are done, and it's going to take about that long for this to cool off, 15 minutes for this to cool off for me to taste it. So I don't know that I should hold you on here for 15 minutes. I can come back on later and let y'all see the cookies and all that. And by that time, Reverend Wood will be home, and then wherever who is it? Peggy. Peggy always wanted. Did Pastor Woodard taste it? Like, girl, he's the chief taster, huh? So I'm gonna come back on later with the cookies, and we're gonna taste the chicken pot pie and the cookies, and let y'all see us because I mean. It's one thing to cook the food, but you want to see folk eat that. Amen. You want to see them eat it. And if the facial expression is, then you know, hey, that stuff is really good. Okay, so I'll come back on a little later after the cookies are done cooking and I get some of these dishes out of the way. And I'll let y'all know how all this stuff tastes, okay? Okay. Bye-bye.